Hey, what's good with y'all boys, man? What's good with y'all niggas, man? Y'all already know it's a good day when that boy Nemo posts, man. It's a good day, man. Hope y'all been doing all right. First thing first, y'all already know. First reaction channel, Smokey Papers. Y'all already know. And y'all know what that mean when a nigga looking down. You gotta get it ready, man. Oh, damn. Hold on, y'all. Hold on. Oh, other way. There we go. Let there be light. There we go. But yeah, man, it is approximately 6:02 in the afternoon. I gotta be up. I gotta go to work in 6 hours. So about to get this last reaction out. About to eat. You know, listen to some music and relax, man. You know, clear my head. Get ready for the work week. You know what I'm saying, bro? Meditate, pray a little bit. You know, you got to get your mind ready, bro. Especially for the shift I work, bro. My stuff is overnight. I work 1 in the morning, y'all, till noon. You know what I'm saying? And I got a crazy week, man. For the next 14 days, I work 12 of them. I work this Wednesday through Sunday. No, this Wednesday through Monday. Let me look at the schedule. Hold up. Yep. I work this Wednesday through Monday, my nigga. So I work tonight. All the way through the motherfucking 5th, and then I'm off the 6th, and then I work the 7th, all the way through the 12th, and I'm off the 13th. So yeah, the next 14 days, bro, I'm working 12 of them, and them motherfuckers is like 11, 12-hour shifts, bro, 1 in the morning to noon. So, you know, ain't no complaining, though, man. You know, we finna get this shit out. I can't complain, bro, because just a few months ago, I was begging for a job, trying to take any job just to scrap up shit, you know, just to get out of the situation I'm in, trying to make ends meet. Still not there yet, but you know, one day at a time, we're gonna get there. But it all starts with a job. As long as you start securing some income, shit'll start slowly but surely changing, man. So, we got Young and Ace, Rekindle 23. We already know. If you don't know, man, unfortunately, he lost his brother about a month ago. His brother passed away. He was killed in his hometown. Not his blood brother, but you know what I'm saying. If you don't know, y'all know who Jada Youngin is. I met and I found out about Ace through Jada Youngin, bro, because like I was hipped on Jada Youngin, you know, off that, you know, that Taking Off, you know, when he dropped that shit had me hooked. You know, when he was doing all his earlier stuff, that shit had me hooked. And I was on Jada Youngin, and out of nowhere, that nigga got the rapping with Ace. Like, you know, he dropped that song with Ace. I'm like, okay, that shit good. And then he dropped Ops with Ace. I'm like, oh yeah, that nigga hard. And that's how I got hipped on Ace. And then, you know, I ain't gonna lie, over the last 3 years, I've been on Ace heavier. But when Jay dropped, I still listened to everything he listened to. But I wouldn't own him nowhere near as heavy as I was on Ace once I found out about him. But here we go, y'all. I got mine rolled. Hopefully you do too. Young and Ace, Rekindle 23. Let's get into it. That's a baby right there from the president. That's the beat, man.
I've been in that water, but I ain't safe. My dog just finna try and lost the case. Couple days before.
What? What? No, bro, no, bro. No, no, bro, y'all telling me, bro, fast car, NASCAR, high speed, ain't no pulling over. I want my gun and my draw, foot the ball, need a, bro, hold on, bro, that right way hard, y'all gotta go listen to that ATK Breezy, that right way. Man, these niggas lightweight, 100 bands on a light day, Cuban Link in his bus down, got me looking like on my ice trip, man, that nigga going in, but I did not know he just lost his fucking trial, bro. I know he been locked up, bro. BZ lost his trial. Wow, yo. We got a spark, nigga.
I've been in that water, but I ain't safe.
That first meaning hit, that's that first bar hit different. I've been in that water, and I ain't, man, look. He lost both brothers, bro. One passed away, and one passed away to the system. That shit crazy as hell.
My dog just finna try and lost the case. Couple days before I was a pawberry and Barry J.
I ain't walk up on his casket when it's up. I ain't want that to be the last time I seen his face. Right. When I see my tip fall, I ain't crying a while, but I seen blood. When it's feeling deep, we ain't lose connects. We ain't talk, but that's still my thug.
Exactly, bro. When you see people like that close to you, you see family, you see people, bro, you don't cry tears, bro. You be crying for vengeance. You be crying for the exact thing that got spilled. You be crying for that blood, bro. You want that shit back. You want them to feel everything you feeling.
I'm buried in Barry J. I ain't walk up on his casket when it's up.
Him,
I ain't
bro. Want to be the he last time I seen his week. Face. He buried Jay a week later. He buried Jay a week later, got the call that Breezy lost his trial. Lost his case.
I seen blood. When it's feeling deep, we lose connects. We
and he still got Queso fighting his case too, bro. Queso still fighting his case.
Talk, but that's still my thug. I felt the soul when I was hugging her tight when I gave his mama a hug. I'm still mad, trying to kindle a flame, but you know it's still love. I'm trying, but it's only so much that a nigga can say. Inside I'm dying. Every day feel like my last morning, I won't be away. With all my love, I've been trying to make this mountain move. I still be trying even though I know it's impossible. How could I be so foolish for believing in love? Know it's a limited moments I got with you and this time ain't enough. Why BZ lost federal trial, I got my head spinning.
Man, did y'all hear that? The same people, bro. NBA Youngboy just won his federal trial. And you seeing that shit is really rare, bro. NBA really did some unthinkable, some real rare shit. He beat a Fed case. Y'all see on the flip, another celebrity. Might not have as much, might have more, but he got cheese too. And he got the money to put the bread up. His homie still lost his Fed case. This nigga Beezy lost his Fed case. Bro, man, look. Hey, that shit played out, bro. If you can, while you can now, get out the street, save yourself, bro. Change your ways. You and your friends, your homies, your dogs, your boys, whatever y'all call them on phone now, whatever you call them, bro. Y'all niggas get to some money before the courts and these systems come get to y'all, bro.
Cause I had peace, I told it, it's been a minute. They say I beat the streets, but I promise it don't seem like I'm winning. God keep a close eye on me, know how I get when I'm healing. Know how I get when I'm dealing. Suicidal thoughts, I be tripping. I've been out of touch with my feelings. Emotionally scarred, but I'm willing. They say I'm weird cause I'm different. I still won't change with these millions. I cry, pain cause I feel it. They ain't say bad news, but I hear it. I'm trying. But it's only so much that a nigga can say. Inside I'm dying. Every day feel like my last morning, I won't be away. Hey, I be trying to move my feet, but my heart just got me stuck. When I start to see that they kill, that's when they show me they don't give a fuck. When I love my heart start beating, I can't let you in easy. Why should I be the one to stay when I know you gon' leave? But Tish wanted me to talk at Jay's funeral. I could, but I was trying to stay strong even though I was vulnerable. Still hurt.
I ain't gonna lie to y'all, bro. This shit low key hitting a little, you know what I'm saying, bro? It's just what he's saying, bro, you know? I'm only saying that, bro, because about 3 years ago, bro, like 2-3 years ago, my grandma passed away, right? And when she, my last grandparent, my dad's mother, my last grandparent, she was the last one alive. She passed away. Bro, I was the only one out of the family. You know, out of my siblings and everybody that didn't get up there and say nothing, bro. Everybody, like, it's like, and it's like, bro, I know exactly what he talking about when he said that last verse where he said the person's name and then he was like, such and such wanted me to get up there and speak on J's behalf, but I couldn't. I was so hurt. Like, bro, I know exactly what he's feeling, bro. Where he talked about he couldn't walk up to the casket when it was open because he couldn't see his mans like that for the last time. I felt that, nigga. I'm not lying. You can ask my dad. You can ask all my brothers and my siblings, bro. I was the last nigga to walk up to that fucking casket to look at my grandma because I dead ass wasn't finna go up there and view her. I literally only went to the funeral, bro, to support my dad because I seen how fucked up he was behind that. If it wasn't for that, bro, I don't do funerals. I wasn't going, bro. And when I went there, I sat my ass right in the chair. Nigga, my auntie duck sat there and stiff-armed the fuck out of my back and said, just get up. She said, at least get up. Bro, I was sitting the fuck there. My row had went. We was the last row. My row had went, bro. I was the last nigga. Like, if it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, I was the 10th nigga in that seat. Everybody else getting up in the line, bro. I'm sitting down. I'm the only nigga in my row sitting down. I was not finna get the fuck up, bro. I was not going for that shit. And I know exactly what he's feeling. And it's, bro, funerals is not, I don't understand that shit. I don't understand it. Who the fuck invented funerals, bro? When it's, I don't know, bro. I don't feel like the same about everybody else when it comes to funerals, bro. When shit is over, it's over, bro. I don't want to see that person, that one, no, bro, no, no, that's some fucked up shit. I don't want to sit there, no, bro, hell no. That nigga was not just like that. My granny was not just like that. So why would I want to see her one last time in the condition I'm not? You know, no, bro.
I lost them two times. We went on good turn before they died. What's that called? This line. Shit, we was fighting, oh, we could have got over it. Had our differences in 2019, but nobody noticed it. I still love you like my brother. I hope you know it. Embracing all my feelings like a boy.
Hey, but that's why you got to tell people you love them while they're here. You got to cherish every moment, bro, because you hear what he said. Some shit they fell out about in 2019, he said people didn't even notice it. 3 years later, we in 2022, bro. They had a little feud. They carrying on for 3 years, bro. You know, brothers fight. But if it's something so small to where he's saying it like that, you got to let that shit go, bro. Because that's the one part where I was just saying, where before I didn't see my granny like that, but now she, I don't want to see her like that, bro. That's the sad reality, bro. Everybody know that day coming. The minute you born, you know you got a day you dying. So you might as well, you know what I'm saying? You know, but yeah, bro. I don't know.
Seen the devil flash right across my eyes. My dreams are seeing the shovel bury me alive. All your friends are here, all my brothers died. Baby, I need you here, just right here by my side. Hold me tight. Feel like bad luck is me, but like I'm cursed. I know everybody go through shit, but I go through the worst. Hurt people. I lie when I said I believe them. I wouldn't be surprised if out of the blue that my heart stopped beating. I showed them my way. I'm trying. But it's only so much that a nigga can say. Inside I'm dying. Every day feel like my last morning, I won't be away. You know, like, real niggas go through shit. You feel me?
Of course, man.
I won't try to hide it, cause I know this shit be real. You feel what I'm saying?
It's life.
I can't hide this shit. This shit just be me and it's who I am.
It's life.
I feel this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, every step of the way is always something else. Every time I open my eyes or something, I close them, something else. Like, wake them open again and something else.
That's
it's
life.
Just my life.
That ain't your life, bro. That's life. That's the cycle of life. It ain't just your life, bro. I know it may feel like that, woe is me, but it ain't just your life, bro. That's life in general, bro. When you go to sleep and wake up, the problems are still there. It's something. And when you go to work, you making money. Believe it or not, bro, the money you making ain't enough, my nigga. I'm saying that for everybody, bro. It's going to always be something, bro. You know, but this song, this shit was beautiful, bro. I ain't even going to lie. This shit low-key, like, fucked me up a little bit because, you know, like, when I be hearing other people grieve and, like, you know, talk and everything, it's like, I ain't even gonna lie, like, I be wishing that I can do that for my granny, bro, because to this day, I haven't cried about her passing, I haven't grieved about her passing, like, at her funeral. I did not cry at her funeral, bro. Like, I went to her funeral because, bro, to this day, I'm mad. Like, it don't feel how it's supposed to feel when somebody passed, bro. Like, when I got the call, bro, I was at work. I was working in the pharmacy on lunch, and my dad called me and told me, bro, you know, your grandmama passed. I was on the way to Chick-fil-A, nigga. Bro, I threw all that fucking food away. I was mad as hell. To this day, from that day he told me to today, anytime I think about it, it caused more anger than more tears and emotion than anything. It made me mad as hell. But I know that day coming, bro. I just hope I'm alone when that day comes. You know, regardless if it's a song, you know, a picture, or, you know, my granny know I loved collard greens, bro. She used to make a big ass pot of collard greens just for me and tell nobody and dead ass mean it. Nobody better not touch that shit or she gonna fuck you up. And she meant it. Bet not nobody touch JJ shit. She wouldn't plan about her JJ, bro. It was like, but man, I know that shit coming, bro. But I just hope I'm alone, bro. Cause you know I ain't trying to be fucked up in front of nobody. I don't like showing weakness or, you know, tears, none of that. I don't like showing that shit in front of people. But I know it's coming, bro. Cause she been gone 3 years. But you never know. Who knows? It might not come, bro. She been gone 3 years and. You never know. That might just be one of them things that sit with me. I just be angry about her passing. I never get over it. But I know that shit might cause some hell down the line. Some emotional damage or some instability because, you know, I'm not fully over or coping with the fact that she gone. Like, you angry over something you can't control. Bro, I talk about it all day, every day. It don't help. But y'all be safe. Stay out the way. Smoke something.